Hi, I'm Daphne Richards, and this is Augie. Our question this week comes from Keith Day, who noticed that the acorns on his live oak trees are oozing a sap-like substance and notes that butterflies, bees, and other insects are flocking to the sticky goo. What's going on? Well, although I've seen many instances of trees oozing sap from the trunk and branches, I've never seen live oaks doing so only from the acorns. One major reason for oozing sap is bacterial infections, which are not a good sign. If the oozing is limited to the acorns, the infection may be limited to that area, and if so, represents no long-term problem for the tree and requires no treatment. These acorns will all fall from the tree soon, and then you should keep an eye out for any other areas of oozing sap. If you had in mind to do some pruning on your tree soon, be sure to hold off until the ideal time, deep in winter, when the trees aren't actively growing and sap isn't flowing. That would most likely be sometime in January, but watch the temperatures to be sure. Winter's not easy to predict these days, with most years much warmer than what we've traditionally considered normal. If you notice sap oozing from any other areas, you might have a bigger problem. And since bacterial infections are not curable, I'd suggest having an arborist out for a visit to get an actual diagnosis and recommendations on how to proceed. For our plant choice this week, we focus on fall blooming bulbs such as oxblood lilies and when to divide them. Many viewers wrote to tell us about this year's fabulous blooms. Vera De La Cruz had some real beauties at Schofield Farms, and Melinda and Jason Deckman had a super show this year too. So when should you divide them? For oxblood lilies and similar plants, any time is fine, but the ideal time would be whenever the leaves start to die back, at which point they're beginning to go into dormancy. The reason that you wait until those leaves die back, but before they go all the way to the ground, is that you can still see them and you know where the bulbs are and where to dig. When you divide those bulbs, be careful not to cut into them. If you do, you may wound it, and then you can leave them on the ground to cure to see if the bulb will heal up. Just make sure that you don't cut into the basal plate. And often we get asked about fertilization. Fertilization is not required when you divide those bulbs and move them. And viewer Anna Evans sent video of migrating monarchs fueling up on zinnias as they head out of town. We'd love to hear from you. Check out klru.org/ctg to send us your questions, pictures, and video.